motorcycle lantern. For this, you will need A4 sheet paper, some crayons and sketch pen. Just that the precipitation and evaporation signs and arrows I'm very particular about, so we'll have to stick to that. To do right now is, first thing is, the sheet that you have taken, you have to fold it in half, okay? You see here, I have folded it in half. The first half is like this, okay? Now, in this half, we need to make the sun and the clouds. So what you need to do is, you need to start making clouds here. Important thing to understand is that your clouds need to be this side. So when you're folding your sheet, just see that the folded side, the cloud needs to come, see, like here, right? So we take this and we go back to our drawing board, and this opening sheet needs to be on the top, and then we need to start making the clouds. Where, how do we make? It needs to open up from this side and from the bottom side, okay? This half part done, now we have to go to the second half. Two-thirds, the rainfall and the evaporation is happening, and one-third, the sea is there, right? On this part, our sea will come, and this part, the evaporation. So this we need to fold in three equal halves. Either you can take a scale and do it, or you can measure it up and do it. You just start folding it into three equal halves. How? What will this give you is this part, where we are going to, and now, in the last part, this section, we have to make the sea. So what do we do is, we keep just go back there and make the sea in the last margin. So you start like from here, just make the waves, but just ensure that your waves are only on the last part of the, so one third part, right? See, I've covered it in the one third part. So now we find the center, and these need to be equal parts. So we have just made one margin here, right? So the center margin, forget about it. Now one, two, three halves you have. Once you have got this, then we start cutting. Now this side, I'm going to make a line so that it is clear to you. So the clouds I am demarcating with a nice big line. Your cut cannot go above this. And here in the sea side also, I am making a nice big line, and your cut cannot go below this. Okay, now understand once again. So your cut has to start from here till here only, and on the other side similarly. So we are not going to cut the clouds, and we are not going to cut the sea. We are going to just cut the place where the raindrops happen. So take a scissor, and in the center the cut, okay? Now I'm going to just turn this around so that you can see how it is working on the other side. Let's just understand the water cycle of what happens in the water cycle. What happens in the water cycle is that the water of the sea gets heated up by the sun, and it rises up. This rising up of the water and turning of water into water vapor is called evaporation. When it rises up, here it condenses and becomes cool, and when it condenses, it becomes heavy. When it becomes heavy is when it precipitates, okay? So we are going to make raindrops and arrow to show the evaporation and precipitation. This is where the condensation happens. And now you can also go completely wild and color your evaporation lantern the way you would want. More important thing is to get the concepts right. So I'm going to just write quickly here, evaporation, and then I'm going to make the arrow of, you know, water going up and actually evaporating. See, like this. So condensation is happening on the clouds. So I'm just going to just say condensation in the clouds. Okay. Precipitation. All right. And then I'm going to make the water droplets. And now you need to turn it around like this and stick it here. Okay. Make a cylinder out of it. So how do we do that? We take a glue, put it on our one side, on the breadth side, not the length side, on the breadth side, because we want a lantern. put a bit of a thread here. So there are these beautiful lanterns, water cycle lanterns, which you can hang from your window